On the 6th of April, 1994, experienced cave divers Jim Bowden and Sheck Exley entered the crisp blue waters of the Zacatón Sinkhole in northeast Mexico. They were there to attempt a record-breaking dive to the very bottom of one of the deepest flooded sinkholes in the world. It was an attempt that had been months, if not years, in the planning, and it was an attempt from which, unfortunately, only one of them would return alive. Sheck Exley started diving at the age of 16. He undertook his first ever cave dive that same year, and it would be an experience that would forever change his life. From that point on, he was hooked on cave diving and dedicated the majority of his time to honing his skills, increasing his knowledge, and planning and executing ever more adventurous diving expeditions. Sheck was the first person in recorded history to log more than 100 cave dives, a feat he managed by the time he turned 23. During the long career that followed, he would go on to log a total of 4,000 dives, many of them technical or cave dives. His extensive experience led him to write two books on the subject, and also to become the first ever chairman of the cave diving section of the American National Speleological Society. He was also responsible for several innovations in safety that benefited all cave divers, including pioneering the practice of having to hand a second, backup regulator. In his personal life, Sheck was greatly admired. He was described as calm, quiet, and mild-mannered by many people who met him. After working for a time in a car dealership, he settled on a career teaching mathematics at a high school in Florida. The job allowed him to travel at the weekends, and he did so often, but also spent a great deal of time on the children he educated. He was popular with his students and often allowed them to call him on the phone if they needed help with their homework. He was respected and admired both as a teacher and by the cave diving community. As well as his intense dedication to cave diving, Sheck's personal physiology also helped him become the prolific diver he was. Over the course of many dives, it became apparent that he was unusually resistant to nitrogen narcosis, a condition that causes temporary confusion and a loss of coordination in divers who descend to great depths. Sheck's career, long as it was not without incident. In 1968, Sheck, then 19, and his brother Edward, 16, were free diving at Wakulla Springs in Florida. The pair were testing their limits to see who could dive the deepest on a single breath hold. No diving equipment was allowed at Wakulla Springs, but the two brothers, with some practice, could dive to depths of 15 meters or 50 feet with nothing more than the air in their lungs. During one such dive, Edward ran out of air before he could return to the surface. Sheck, already exhausted from repeated free dives, ran to his car to retrieve an oxygen tank he had stored there, but collapsed before he could use it to try and rescue his brother. Another diver who happened to be present was able to use the tank to retrieve Edward, who passed away later that day in hospital. The death of his brother was a terrible blow for Sheck and fueled his desire for greater safety in diving. He later noted that his passion for cave diving ran so deep that he was unable to give it up, but that he was desperate to make the practice safer for all those who undertook it. A few years later, in December 1970, Sheck was working as a safety diver in the Bahamas. Two other divers were attempting to set the record for the deepest dive using only compressed air. Divers who travel to great depths rarely use only compressed air, as the mixture of gases therein can cause severe medical issues when breathed under pressure. Nitrogen narcosis and oxygen toxicity are just two of the risks that have to be considered when diving using air and not other gases. During this dive, Sheck reached a depth of 142 meters, or 465 feet, before starting to suffer confusion, dizziness, and the beginnings of a blackout. With his unusual resilience, he was able to safely return to the surface. The two divers who were attempting to break the depth record had, however, gone deeper. They were unable to return and passed away under the water. This experience left Czech with a general skepticism for big high-profile dives with commercial sponsorships and media coverage. He repeatedly espoused his view that it was better to be cautious, avoid outside pressure to succeed, and be ready to abort a dive at a moment's notice if something appeared to be going wrong. On the 6th of April, 1994, Czech Exley and a fellow diver named Jim Bowden attempted a dive at the Zacatón Sinkhole in Mexico. They were joined by several supporters and safety divers who would prepare equipment, monitor their dives, and generally assist in the attempt. The sinkhole, or cenote, is a deep, vertical shaft surrounded at the surface by sheer cliffs. On the surface of the warm, clear water float several islands of zacate grass. It is from these that the sinkhole gets its name. Rather than risking the sheer cliff walls above the main pool, Czech and Jim would enter the water from a side pool and swim through a short tunnel to the main pool before beginning a rapid but carefully controlled descent to the bottom over 300 meters, or 1,000 feet, below. They would descend in parallel, following separate weighted lines, spaced a short distance apart. As he approached a depth of 268 meters, or 874 feet, Jim checked the amount of gas he had left in his tank, and noticed with alarm that it was significantly less than he had anticipated. He immediately stopped his dive and began to ascend, a process that would take more than 9 hours because of the need to stop regularly and decompress on the way up. Failure to stop and decompress could cause the bends, a debilitating and sometimes fatal illness that divers often experience when returning from depth too quickly. The reason why Jim had less gas available than expected has not been definitively determined, but could be due to a number of factors. He may simply have been breathing slightly faster or slightly more deeply than he had calculated he would. Even a slight increase in rate of breathing is enough to catastrophically deplete a diver's gas reserves. While Jim ascended slowly to the surface, a safety diver followed Czech's line down to try and determine what had happened to him. Had he also used up more gas than anticipated? And if so, why hadn't he turned around? The safety diver was unable to see him, but did spot the laminated pages of his dive profile floating up towards the surface, a definite sign that all was not well. Less than 20 minutes into the dive, it became clear that Czech Exley would not return. His body would be recovered a few days later when the support team returned to remove the equipment they had put in place for the dive. It appeared that he had deliberately entangled himself in the line. Other divers have speculated that he did so when he realized that he was in fatal difficulty, in order to make the subsequent retrieval of his body easier. As to exactly what difficulty had ended his life, there were no certain answers. One likely scenario was that he suffered high-pressure nervous syndrome, a disorder caused by rapid changes in pressure, which can cause convulsions, tremors, nausea, dizziness, and confusion. These symptoms, while not immediately deadly in and of themselves, might have distracted Czech from the fact that he had used more gas than anticipated, resulting in further complications as the dive progressed. Equipment failure or a sudden blackout are also possible explanations. Czech was laid to rest with a memorial service at the Ortega Methodist Church in Jacksonville. Jim Bowden, despite suffering some effects of decompression sickness, made a full recovery and continued to dive for many years. The Zacatón Sinkhole remains a prominent diving location, and a site of great scientific interest. Sheikh Exley will never dive there again, but his legacy lives on. The passion and dedication he displayed during his life made cave diving a safer practice for all those who follow after him.